beseech me not unto thee. How now, brown cow? Oh, thy soul is so dry. If I could just catch a morsel of who you are. So verily, merrily, down the stream. This next person is focused on things they want and not their needs. They create lists of things they desire to keep up with the Joneses.
When I get my prayer on, there are some things that I keep in mind. I think it's totally awesome that God is like Santa Claus, and he wants to give you the things that you want. Therefore, you need to keep a list of these things. My list has 745 prayer requests on it. So then, when I go to the Lord in prayer, it goes a little something like this. I'll just pray real quick. Guess it's just best to start with, numero uno. The first thing on my list is my mom, and so I'll pray for her now. Dear Heavenly Father, I lift up this sweet, saltable lady that you have blessed me with to be my mother, and I tell you thank you. And although I know I'm called to respect her, I give her all due respect. There's also an issue with something she truly needs, and this is to stop the yapping. Lord, she yaps, and she doesn't know how to stop yapping. So could you please just make her mute? I mean, just for a day, nothing permanent. Don't hurt her. I love her, just mute her. You know, kind of like the television. When that commercial comes on, you just take out your big God remote and push mute on her channel. That would be great. Henceforth, I go on and pray for all 744 things.
And finally, when all pretenses are stripped away, we come to a person who's honest in his prayer and prays in a way very reminiscent of the way that Jesus taught us. God, you are more real than anything this world has to offer. And I can't wait for you to come back and get us. But until that time comes, would you just help me live my life day after day, as if I'm walking hand in hand with you. God, I have a lot of needs, and I have a lot of wants. And sometimes I get those things confused. Help me to trust you, to meet my needs, and be thankful when you give me those other things that I just want. God, I've blown it so many times today, and I'm sorry. Thank you for your forgiveness. I don't take it for granted. And God, as I start this day out, I'm just reminded that this world is filled with so many spiritual potholes. Please help me to walk in such a way that I won't stumble so much. And as I'm going through this day, help me to live my life in such a way that would bring you glory and honor. May the life that I live be a life of worship to you. Amen. And now if you'll stand with us and pray and say our Apostles' Creed, number 881, in your hymnal, and then we will finish with our final song, God Will Take Care of You, which is number 130. Let's profess what we believe. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now number 130, God will take care of you. Made abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.